And women in our industry are coming into their own more and more.
The Queens of Country reigned over the taping of the CBS special, Women of Country. The special airs in early 93.
Now, one of the ladies featured in Women of Country celebrated a birthday in October, as well as several other noteworthy occasions. But most importantly, 1992 marked 20 years of terrific, talented, and always tantalizing Tanya Tucker.
Record says it all. Tanya Tucker is the only female in country music who had number one hits 20 years ago and continues that process today. October brought Tanya her first platinum award for What Do I Do With Me.
After being in country music for 20 years, a platinum album is really a reward that I've been wanting for a long time.
Good for you, Tanya. It's been worth the wait.
Well, as we all arrived at the port of Miami.
If striking a balance between family and the road is tough for stars who are married, imagine what it's like for single mother Tanya Tucker. Not that she's complaining.
I know a lot of single mothers out there don't have near the help I do, and they don't get to stay with their children as much because they have jobs, 9 to 5. I get to take my children on the road, and I feel really blessed because of that.
With us a couple of nights ago when we brought you the first look at Tanya Tucker's new video, Two Sparrows in a Hurricane, the song is a love story that really holds special meaning for Tanya.
It does, and although it's just been released, Kip Kirby found out it's already striking a sentimental chord among listeners.
Like two sparrows in a hurricane, trying to find their way. With a head full of dreams and faith that can move anything.
Tanya Tucker didn't write Two Sparrows in a Hurricane. Nonetheless, it tells a story that she feels very close to.
It's about two people that got married when they were very young, and the hard times they went through, the babies, and then growing old together, and then eventually dying together, and find a way, you know, and it's just one of those perfect dream love stories, and it's just like my parents. They're celebrating their 50th anniversary next year in January, so I thought it was really fitting.
The video is really a family affair. Daughter Presley and son Beau Grayson are in it. So is their father, LA actor Ben Reed. Helping to complete the family theme is the person Tanya chose to portray her as an older woman, Presley's godmother, Mae Axton.
She's 83 and he's barely driving the car.
When she wanted me, I felt it was one of the greatest compliments anyone could pay me. That she wanted me to be involved in this family circle, so to speak.
They mean especially, you know, after Elvis, and of course, Mae Axton wrote Heartbreak Hotel. So everything sort of fits together. I mean, my parents got married when they were 15, and it's just kind of all fitting together.
Indeed, it fits so well, and the story parallels her parents' life story so closely that the video is dedicated to them.
It's a real emotional song. A lot of people have been crying on the set, you know.
The world says they'll never make it. But love says they will.
Pretty yeah. Song. Now, Tanya's new album called Can't Run From Yourself should be released on October.
Tanya Tucker celebrates her biggest year in country music.
I'll be showing it off. Walk in the door. Hello, do you see my ago record? Come right this way.
Our celebrity profile has been in the music business for over 20 years, and I think we can safely say right now is her highest moment.
Yeah, her current album, What Do I Do With Me, is her first gold album mm-hmm. in 13 years. In fact, I think this one is actually close to platinum.
Million sales, right. Well, Tanya's first CMA award came last year, so with all this happening, you can imagine that she is busier than ever. Well, Capitol Records even had a hard time catching Tanya to celebrate their first gold album with her. Well, Capitol Nashville's president Jimmy Bowen managed to do it last night, and Renee Goodman was there.
Your career couldn't be any better place than it is right now. We're so proud for you and happy for you. And here's your first gold record.
All right. An award definitely adds pressure. I mean, but nothing that I haven't already had enough of already.
Yeah.
So I think probably it just makes you, it just shows you got to work twice as hard next year, twice as hard this year.
If that's possible. Tanya won CMA Female Vocalist of the Year last October, but just now is finding time to be presented the award. She was busy having her second child the night the awards were given out.
Were you just kind of just as happy to not have to go to the podium?
Well, to be honest, yes. I mean, that's a lot of pressure off you right there. I mean, that speech, I mean, to make that speech is really... Did you know you're going to always leave someone out? You're going to forget. It's a lot of pressure. And to be there just waiting for you, you know, just thinking about maybe your name might be called. And then if it's not, you're like, well, you know. And then if you are, which I've never felt before, you know, you're trying to think, what would I say if I did win? So a lot of pressure was off of me at that point, but I figured I had enough pressure for one day already.
Bo Grayson is now 3 months old and is already hitting the parties with Sister Presley. But Tanya admits it's a little tougher to carry two babies around.
Woo! It's extremely tough. You got to be careful you don't pay more attention to one than the other. You got to take twice the stuff, especially when you have a boy and a girl, so it's totally different stuff. I like having two little girls. You put her socks on, you know. It's a lot tougher, but it's really a rewarding and beautiful, beautiful thing. Really beautiful experience for me.
Do you think that winning these honors is putting more demands on you, on your time, like you have to be here and there?
Definitely. You know, you just can't take off and go to Florida when you want to, you know. But I am leaving tonight.
Had a hard day's work.
Yes, I'm getting out of town. I'm out of here. I'm going to go to a cutting. So ride my horse and enjoy myself for a few days. But then when I get back, it's right back to it, you know. It's not just an instinct now to be on top. It's an instinct now to have a bigger voice and raise a bigger voice and hopefully help those that are less fortunate. You know, I think that's probably my big motto this year.
What a year for Tanya. She does plan on being at the Grammy Awards this year. She's up for Best Country Performance by a Female for Down to My Last Teardrop.
And, you know, this is Tanya's third Grammy nomination. Back in 1981, she won a Best Recording for Children Grammy. It was for the album Sesame Country.
Oh, hey, more important business here we have to take care of.
Aaron.
Our workout with Aaron Tippett contest is winding down. Two more days left to enter. So